Hello and welcome back to my little series about the mathematics of tennis. Last time we looked at the probability space omega f and p, and omega and f is a measurable space and p will be the probability function which is a measure so far. And how does it look like? So in our case we have omega is success and failure. Either you win the set or you don't. And F is the power set of omega, which is empty set, success, failure, and omega. P goes from F to 0, 1, as we have seen. And now let's have a look at the elements of F. So P of empty set is 0, of course, and P of omega is 1 by definition. P of success is p, little p, with little p between 0 and 1. Certainly not 0 and not 1, because then it would be boring. And p of omega is the same as p of success plus p of failure. Because those both are distinct events, and this is and therefore P of failure is the same as 1 minus P. Those verbal descriptions of events like failure and success are okay for the moment. But we can also describe these events with numbers. And in order to do that, we will introduce a function x. So now I will tell you something about random variables. So a random variable is a function x that goes from omega to r, to the real numbers. And now we can say, okay, we take success to 1, maybe, and failure to 0. And this is a nice little function, and it's called a random variable for omega. We have to be a little bit careful with random variables. I just defined a function, but random variables have to respect the sigma algebra F in a certain way that I will describe now. We go from omega to R, so we have to have a look at R. And in R, we have intervals like AB. So what is AB? That is the set of all x in R with A lesser x lesser B. So that is AB. It's an open interval in R, and let M be the set of all open intervals, all AB in R with A lesser B and sorry for that, A lesser B, and A, B, and Q. So they both have to be rational. And now we call the set of all countable unions, intersections, and relative complements of members of M the Borel sigma algebra of R, and we denote it with B1. So B1 is the sigma algebra that we get from M. So M takes the role of omega here, and B1 takes the role of F, like in the other case. So B1 is the sigma algebra for M, we can say, or a certain sigma algebra. Of course, M is an infinite set, and there is more than one sigma algebra to M, but this is a really special one that is used all the time. And now we can define a probability function on B1, so that will be interesting. So we want to have Px, which goes from B1 to R. And we will have a look at Px. As you might know, x was defined with x of success is 1, and x of failure is 0. Of course, success and failure are sets in F. So say Px of B should be 0 if B doesn't contain zero or one, and it should be P if okay, zero is not in B, but one is in B, and Px of B is 1 minus P if 1 isn't in B but 0 is in B. And of course Px of B is 1 if 0 and 1 are in B. So Px is similar to P, but it's a little bit more sophisticated, and it's another probability space. It's not the same. It's R with B1 and Px. And it describes the same experiment as omega, F, and P do. That is the important lesson from that. And now we can have a look at how to win a match best of three. Best of three, how can we win that? Okay, there are always two possibilities, so we can draw a little tree. And A wins with probability P, and B wins with probability Q. Q is 1 minus P. So this is the first set. The second set is A wins with probability P, B with probability Q, A with P, B with Q. This is the second set. And in the third set, in the case that A has won the first two sets, it's not necessary to do anything, so it's just one. And if A and B have won the first and the second set, then we have this probability P and Q that A wins and that B wins. Of course, the same holds if B wins the first set and A the second set. That means we have A and B with probabilities P and Q. And in the last case, we don't have to play. And with probability 1, B wins. Okay. Now we can state who is the winner in each case. So the winner of this line is A, of course. And here we have also A, because A won the first and the third set. Here the winner is B. And along this line, the winner is A. Along this line, the winner is B. And along this line, the winner is B. Now we can have a look at the probabilities. This is P for the first set and P for the second set. And 1 for the third set, which isn't played out, so we have P to the square. So they multiply along that path, and in the second line we have P, Q, and P along this, so it's P square Q. P Q squared, Q P squared, so P squared Q, and here we have Q P Q, P Q squared, and here we have Q squared. So these are the probabilities for all cases, and now we just have to add them up for player A and for player B, and then we will get the probability of winning the match. So I will just write it down here. The probability of the event that A wins the match is P squared plus P squared Q plus P squared Q, which is of course P squared times 1 plus 2Q, and the probability that B wins the match is kind of the same with the opposite letters, so we have P Q squared plus P Q squared plus Q squared, which is of course Q squared times 1 plus 2P. And that is the solution for our problem.